What is a demon magician? A demon magician is a human who knowingly or unknowingly is aided by a demon in his performances, where teleportation, levitation, mind reading, and other forms of supernatural activity is performed.
Sorry, I don't understand. How is that not real? What do you mean it looks pretty real? What? This is all glue?
In most cases, the demon magician knows that the entity that is levitating, teleporting, or passing on information to the magician is a demonic spirit, but not always. Sometimes the demons trick the human into believing that the entity is the ghost of a human.
He sat me down and he told me that he had done his meditations and that he had spoken with his wife and that he had spoken with the angels, and they had come to him and they had told him that this is what he needs to do.
Santana's angels are really devils who are using Santana to communicate Satan's age-old lie that we are gods.
Like, yeah, okay. Yeah, I want to get tapped into what he's doing.
But sometimes they even pretend to be ghosts of aliens or ascended masters or other types of fictional beings. High-level occultist Manly P. Hall revealed in his book, The Secret Teachings of All Ages, that humans have throughout history made deals with demonic spirits in return for supernatural assistance. It is clear to anyone who researches the occult that demons can also possess human beings and take full control over them, and control their body and vocal cords with flawless precision. However, it is not clear why demonic possession sometimes results in the eyes changing, and sometimes not. Ask, what do demons gain from helping their human assets become rich and famous by winning highly competitive talent shows such as America's Got Talent? The main reason is that demons want to recruit as many humans to the occult as possible. In doing so, they are building up an army of humans that are loyal to demons. Obviously, it is the demons themselves who decide who they want to recruit, and they pick based on existing talent, looks, and charisma. A contract is then signed, usually involving blood. The magician, artist, or musician is then made aware that he is not allowed to do anything unless the demon assigned to him permits it. Obviously, the human is aware that the demon has the right to end the human's life if the human even thinks about betraying the contract. The demons make it very clear that they are able to read the magician's mind, and thus, the magician will forever live in a mental prison, never daring to reveal any secret. Demonic partnership with humans is obviously not limited to artists, but also all elite professions on Earth. Demons have been highly involved with the human elite since the dawns of creation, and have no reason to stop. Most notably, ancient Babylon, ancient Sumer, ancient Egypt, Maya, Aztec, the British Empire, and now the American Empire.
The most violent country in the world in the 19th century, by far, was perhaps the most democratic or second most democratic, and that was Britain. You could be democratic at home and ruthlessly imperial abroad. The most violent country in the world since 1950 has been the United States.
It's Jeff, been by let's, far involved Jeffrey, in stop war, now. In more let's, wars. Let's, Jeffrey, I'm Jeffrey, I'm your moderator.
And now the American Empire. In the Bible, modern-day America seems to be referred to as Babylon, the dwelling place of demons. The Bible mentions that the closer we get to the end times, that more and more humans would be deceived into following doctrines of devils and teachings of demons. It says that their goal is to unite the world against God, and their main tool would be deception, followed by the mark of the beast, in other words, a single world government, ruled by them.
This is a lady from Brazil who levitates. She is unlike other street performers who appear to levitate but do not actually levitate. This woman simply walks up to a certain area in full view of others and begins to levitate. Some might argue that she is able to hold her body weight up with her cane. But that argument fails because she removes her hands completely from the cane and still levitates. In some instances, she will switch hands. This is unlike other street performers who appear to levitate. Their arm or one side of their body remains connected to a metal box underneath. Those street performers are hooked up to a contraption that allows them to appear as if they are floating. Also, anyone can watch those street performers and see that at the beginning of the day, they assemble their device. And at the end of the day, they disassemble their device. The fact that those performers are not actually levitating can be discovered by anyone who waits until the end of the day to see their contraption disassembled. But this woman from Brazil walks right up to the crowds and begins to levitate. She is not hooked up to any device. While floating, she will switch the hand that holds the cane and even take both hands off the cane. A human who is not using a machine or a device is not able to float in the air without spiritual assistance.
Thank you.
Shin Lim is a famous American magician. Growing up, it was his desire to become a professional piano player, but at college he developed carpal tunnel syndrome in both hands. He then decided to become a professional magician, and in only a few years he has already become one of the top magicians in the world. He can cause things to instantly appear and disappear.
All right, watch once more. You can actually see the coin vanish and then reappear. Watch once more. Up. We'll do it again, but this time with a deck of cards. Whoa.
Shin is the only two-time winner on America's Got Talent, winning in consecutive years Season 13 in 2018 and America's Got Talent, The Champions in 2019. In this clip, Shin Lim says that he uses black art to perform his, quote, tricks.
You know, some of you guys are thinking it's CGI or editing. Excuse me, if you don't know any of my work, I use black art, which we all know.
One of the definitions for black art is witchcraft. This video on the life of Shin Lim quotes Shin saying, "This was so amazing, like I can learn sorcery."
As he started to improve his skills and develop his own tricks, Lim had a revelation. "This was so amazing, like I can learn sorcery," says Lim.
One of Shin Lim's friends is a card magician whom Shin calls Sexy and says, "Don't tell his wife Casey."
He's so sexy.
Don't tell Casey I said that.
Shin Lim got his own show at the Mirage in Las Vegas. On the show, he works with world-famous Scottish mentalist magician Colin Cloud. Here, Shin and Colin talk about those who believe that the judges or audience members are paid actors in on their magic acts, or that their magic is done with CGI.
They're not like what they show is just like, you know, it's
wrong.
Happens.
It's really wrong.
Absolutely. Yeah. But it's funny people saying, yeah, well, you must use stooges or the judges or
anyone. Yeah.
And the truth is, genuinely, we can, like, in our shows on TV, like, nobody's in on it. And, like, I used to get really upset when I first started doing AGT. I was on season 12 and people saying, oh, he's using stooges or plants or they're all actors. Or
yeah.
And to start, I was like, oh, this is really upsetting. And then you realize, actually, if that's the only way that you can think,
it's a compliment.
I'm like,
it's a compliment.
Amazing.
Yeah. I mean, people say the same thing about this.
Exactly.
It's edits, it's CGI. I'm like, bro, this was recorded live, man. How can it be CGI?
Yeah, like,
like, there's no way. But,
yeah, genuinely, if we were using stooges or camera tricks, like,
for the show,
we would, I'd be disappointed with myself. Like, hand on heart, can honestly say we don't use stooges. Yeah. And because of that, I recommend you come and see the show at the Mirage. Two or three times.
Yeah. So then that way you can see that we don't use
every night. It's different people. You know, everything happens raw, as you said. It's different. But yeah, I now take that, as you said, as a compliment.
Yeah,
so
you have to,
exactly. So people that think we do that, then
thank you.
Thanks, Tim. Yeah.
And keep saying.
Honored. Yeah.
Shin Lim's friend Colin Cloud joined a company called Tree of Knowledge in 2007. The tree of knowledge of good and evil in the book of Genesis is the one tree that God commanded Adam and Eve not to eat from, otherwise they would die. Under the form of the serpent, the devil deceived Eve to eat the fruit from this tree. He lied to her, assuring her that she wouldn't die, but would be as God. This is Colin's featured image for his Twitter account on July 23, 2019. His featured tweet says, "Sinful." The message describes his 2019 show called Sinful. About this show, Colin says, quote, "Warning, not for the faint-hearted, just the dark-hearted." He closes his statement with a picture of a demon or the devil. Colin also promotes as hashtags the words sin, sinner, devil, Satan, and Lucifer. Here are some quotes about his show Sinful from his website colincloud.com. "Some sins are deadly, some are delicious. In Sinful, Cloud will charm the demons in your head. Colin will reveal why it's so much more fun to ask for forgiveness than permission, and why enough is never enough. Colin will explore your psyche and show why you are driven by desire. Get ready to discover why you are sinful and proud of it. This Edinburgh festival let Colin Cloud find out exactly how original your sins can be. He might even indulge in a few delicious sins of his own. One promotional features just an apple. That's obviously a reference to eating or taking a bite out of the forbidden fruit. In this poster promoting Sinful, Colin Cloud features a tattoo of a serpent on his right hand. Chloe Crawford was Colin's special guest magician. Crawford tours as a magician and has been featured on the magic show The Illusionist as, quote, the sorceress. Colin Cloud's July 25, 2019 tweet says, retweet for evil. During an online YouTube video show, a blindfolded man tries to guess who Colin is and he guesses that he is a porn star. Colin responds, quote, I wish.
Ask other yeah, questions.
She's in Vegas. You're a porn star.
I wish.
The magician who calls herself the Sacred Rihanna was the winner of Asia's Got Talent 2017. She has described herself as, quote, we.
The Sacred Rihanna, after that performance, which the judges have all agreed was amazing, how do you feel?
We are happy.
In Mark 5:9, Jesus asks the unclean spirit possessing a man what his name is, and the demon responds, quote, my name is Legion, for we are many. Throughout history, men and women have sold their souls to the devil for temporal benefits. Here are shirts for sale that promote or encourage children to sell their souls to the devil or make deals with the devil. Here are some I sold my soul to Crowley shirts for sale. Here's a shirt for sale that promotes child ritual sacrifice. Here's another shirt for sale that promotes summoning demons. There are people on YouTube who have openly sold their souls to the devil.
What's up, guys? Back with another one. As you tell by the title, yes, today I'm gonna sell my soul to the devil for fame and fortune, guys. I don't know. It's sort of weird, guys. I'm not saying I believe in selling your soul and all that kind of stuff, but I'm gonna give it a chance, all right, guys? So today's the day, guys. I'm selling my soul. Why hide it, guys? Like, why not just be open with it? Hey, if it works, you guys are gonna know for sure that this stuff is actually existing in the universe. And if it doesn't work, well, you know that it's all bull. Alright guys, so believe it or not, this video took a lot of preparation. Like, seriously, I took 3 days to prepare for this. And it's all in this book right here, guys. It's called Gems from the Equinox by Aleister Crowley. So in this book, you can tell right away it's real just because of the Egyptian stuff all over the place, guys. But basically, this book has a lot of things to do with selling your soul, guys. Also, it has a lot to do with black magic and all that kind of stuff, guys. But before we start this, guys, I just want to let you know that in no way am I condoning people to do this. Like, do not do this. I don't know if it works, guys. I don't know if it works. I've been sort of like the test dummy for like demonic rituals on my channel for a while now. So if anybody's gonna understand, it's gonna be you guys. All right, so please don't hate on the video, guys. Another thing, I believe in God, all right? I don't believe in Satan. I don't worship Satan, all right? No matter what kind of tattoos I got. For real, I believe in God, all right? So I don't wanna hear all this devil worshiping stuff, guys. It's just a video, man. I'm just trying it out, bro. Let's see if it works, dude. Like, literally, I wanna be a YouTuber more than anything. Why not sell my soul? Why not? Like, that's what I wanna do. If I can't do this, I just wanna die, okay? Like, literally, I wanna do this more than anything, all right? So let's just get that understood, all right? And if it don't work, look, I'm still trying YouTube anyways. All right, 13 candles, guys. I got 13 blue candles. I got this Ouija board thing right here. It's really cool. We're gonna make a pentagram with this salt. Basically, a pentagram is just a big star with a circle around it, guys. And basically, I do like demonic rituals at 3 o'clock in the morning, guys. I got my whole channel full of that stuff. And trust me, after doing this for months, I definitely believe in demonic spirits and presences. And it's scary. I'm not gonna lie, guys. This is scary. I'm really scared to do this. I recommend not to try it. Do not try it at home. This is my disclaimer right now. Don't try this. All right, guys. So I learned a lot from this book lately, guys. I read this whole entire thing in the last 3 days. And what I came to understand was the afterlife, the spiritual realm. It has a lot to do with patterns, numbers. Life is really like a video game, guys. And if you guys have ever played a video game before, you know that there's hacks and there's cheats. You might press up, down, left, right, A, B. And if you press these
all in the same order, all at the same time, all in the proper place in the game, something magic will happen. Your character will get superpowers. You'll be able to slow time and do all this crazy stuff. And life is a lot like this from what I understand. Everybody knows all these celebrities, they sold their soul, all right? Now it's my turn, all right? Where's my fame? Where's my money at? I'm still in a friggin' one-bedroom apartment, guys. It's time to step it up a notch. I also writ out the contract, guys. All right, guys, so here is where it gets real. I have to sit in this pentagram for as long as it takes, guys, and I have to chant. I'm already feeling like a cold wind on me. I'm really scared. I'm actually shivering right now all of a sudden. I don't know why. But yeah, guys, I'm really scared, so I'm just gonna sit here and chant. I'm not a devil worshiper. I'm just doing this for the whole purpose of the ritual and making this video pretty much for like documentation reasons. Like, does this actually exist? Like, someone has to do a test. Like, it's gonna be me. All right, I'm gonna test it out. Apparently after chanting this, I'm gonna start to feel the presence of a demon, and once I start to feel that presence, I have to cut my thumb or any part of my hand and basically just stick it right here underneath my name. I gotta stop explaining this to you guys and just go on with this whole thing. Whoa, guys. Okay, I'm feeling the presence already, guys. I seriously feel the presence. I don't know if you guys can see this. Like, I got serious goosebumps. Wow. Guys, I'm so scared. Okay, I'm just gonna go ahead and sign this thing, guys, because like I said, I feel the presence already. So I'm not gonna show you, but I'm taking the scissors and I'm gonna sign this thing, just like I told you guys. All right. All right, there it goes, guys. Officially sold my soul right now. In 1 year, this should be all delivered, guys. I'm just gonna blow this out real quick because I'm scared. I really did feel the presence of a demon, guys. Like, I can't fake goosebumps on my body. Like, I'm sorry, I really can't fake that. You're gonna have to take my word, guys. Like, I did this 100%. Like, I closed my window so no light would come in this room for 3 days. Like, I seriously want this to work, or I don't want to sell my soul to Satan, basically, but I did.
I'm actually reading a real script, seance script that was wrote up back in the day, and this is how people would sell their soul to the devil. So we are doing this the legitimate way. Now, again, the outcome, I don't know how that's going to go. I don't believe anything bad will happen. But everything we're doing is according to, I don't want to say the book because it's not a book, but it's the way that it has been done in the past. Let us know what you think.
My name is Jake Weber, and I'm going to make a deal with the devil. This deal is called the Crossroads Ritual. I will be handing over my soul in exchange for whatever I ask for. And I'm going to be doing this on Halloween night.
If there are people who will come out and tell the whole world that they are selling their souls to the devil, how many more people do you think have privately sold their souls?
Hello, my name is Jabrizi, the new Jesus. I've been called the devil. I've been called God. I'm the hip-hop illusionist, and I'm ushering in a new era of magic.
At the age of 13, I got diagnosed with Crohn's disease, so I wasn't able to go outside for about a good 2 years. So I said, if I get one more chance, I want to do magic because I want to make my impact on this world.
One of Jabrizi's videos is called Magician Really Sells His Soul.
Did I sell my soul? A common question I'm asked. Let's find out the truth. So to answer that question, yes, I did sell my soul to do magic. Soul.
I'm a magician hitting the streets and doing magic. Becoming this generation's best magician alive.
In this video, Jabrizi puts up a graphic multiple times in which the two words sold and soul can be spelled out. In other words, he is telling you that he sold his soul. Jabrizi doesn't say he sold his soul to the devil, but claims to have given his life completely to magic. But after the sold soul title appears, he says he is, quote, becoming this generation's best magician alive, and gives the devil's horn symbol with both of his hands. This clearly indicates to those who understand the hand symbol that he gives credit to the devil for what is happening in his life, and that he did sell his soul to the devil for magic powers.
I showcase a legendary journey like no other. My mission, to wake up as many people as possible to their own strength.
Although all magicians who have special powers are possessed, whether they know it or not, not all magicians have explicitly sold their souls to the devil. But there are many magicians who have. The evidence indicates that Jabrizi is a magician who did sell his soul to the devil.
Do not tell me what to do at all. Like, I'm not gonna listen. Like, I do whatever I want.
I want to be literally the most influential person alive. Ooh. I believe. I don't even think, I think I'm bigger than the idea of magic. I am magic.
These are like my pimp shoes now.
So to get this started off the right way, I'm going to do a magic trick to some ladies, man. Because I'm a ladies, man. And the first trick is going to be with the condom.
Wait, let the camera get close in on this. Check it out, watch. Watch the condom. If the pin is here, then that must mean that the pencil is here. Watch this. If the pencil is here, then that must mean that the pin is. Here.
Look at him, baby!
You know which way?
Oz Perlman might be the most well-known mentalist magician in America. After stunning some radio show hosts, one of them asks Oz if he works with the dark arts. Oz responds, quote, "I sold my soul."
How?
How?
I don't like
Stay
it.
Away from my mom.
I need to go take a bath.
How do you know my mother?
Stay away from my mom.
My heart is beating quickly.
Didn't you notice I was sweating and shaking over here?
I think I'm sweating.
It doesn't feel right.
It doesn't feel right. Something's wrong. Is there you in the dark arts?
That's what I was saying.
I sold my soul.
Here Oz does a quote trick and says quote seems evil and then says quote evil.
If you wouldn't mind, strike a match.
You know,
this is so fun.
And fire.
Oh!
Now, wait, don't move, because I said water. Come back, Chanel. And...
I thought you were about to drop flames.
She's like, what's about to happen? The craziest thing, there was a study where they did this.
Freezing, by the way.
Seems evil.
Yeah,
you
nice.
Can drop
nice.
It. Now, that's the thing. It feels cold, right?
It does.
Where they did a study where they took a match and they conditioned somebody that they were going to burn them. Evil.
But where right. did the ice come from?
That's, I know. They're all
like your
over. Al's full
wet.
Of it.
Nothing's
I know. Frisk
wet.
Me to see if I'm wet right now.
That's what
no,
I'm saying. Kidding. Nothing's wet.
Al, stop.
That's what I was going to
wow.
say.
That's amazing.
He said, I want you to think back. Hear me out. My name is Oz Perlman. I live in New York City, and I'm a professional mentalist. First audition, America's Got Talent, I did something for Mel B.
I am picturing a vacation to Fiji that
Yay!
Happened in 1998.
To say she was freaked out was an understatement. I think she was about to throw holy water at me.
The dream is getting to the NBA, baby. That's the dream. Trey.
Yeah.
30 cards,
yep.
Name the teams. Every single one of these are different. Make sure all the NBA teams are
They're all there. I'm seeing them
different
all.
Players, say them. New seeing Orleans.
Denver Nuggets, okay. Sacramento
Mike,
Kings
take
are all
the
there.
Cards.
Okay.
And this is important. Game time decision.
I want you to
put it in your hand. A certain amount. Could be half, could be less. One in each hand. Take a group in each hand. You ready? You decide. This is all you. Throw one of them over your shoulder. Get rid of one half. Gone. I don't care. I don't want them.
Gone.
Spread the other ones between your hands. Decide whether you want a big group, small group, right in the middle. Spread them out in your hands. Either amount, you're going to get some NBA teams. Take them apart. You decide right now. One of them's going over your head. Are you going with the right hand again or left?
See, right hand again.
Go for
oh.
it. All right, now this is it. You've got a few cards left.
Okay.
You're making the choices. I see five or six cards. Point to one.
Okay.
And are you sure you want that one
that
right there?
One right
are you
there.
Sure? I don't want to touch it. You
that
grab
one.
Grab out that team. Don't let me see. Very important. You're going to see a team. It's going to prompt you for a player as well. Did you see it?
Yes.
I'm getting rid of these. I don't
okay.
want them. So right now, you're seeing the NBA.
Uh-huh.
30 teams, hundreds of players. Yes. You've got a player on a team in mind.
Yes.
Why do we love March Madness? Because you don't know what's going to happen.
That's
Thursday,
correct.
Thursday, a number one seed might drop to a number 16 seed. You don't
it's
know.
Never happened.
Buzzer beater, it might happen this year.
It might, but it I might. Wouldn't go with it.
Mike, rip up the card. Rip it into shreds. Rip it. Gone.
Rip it
up. This is a thought in your mind. I'm not a magician. I'm a mentalist. Rip it up. You got your player. You got your team.
Okay. I kind of think you're a demon at this point.
Oh, and this is that moment. The swoosh, the throw. Throw it through here. Get rid of it. Get rid of it. And oof, it's getting hot in here. Is it getting hot in here?
Yeah.
Tell us all. Tell us all right now. No trick, no nothing. What team out of every single one of those teams? Which one of those teams? Grab that mic for me. Grab that hot mic.
You're gonna do a jersey reveal?
It was.
What team was that?
It was the Lakers.
Lakers, yeah.
A lot of players on the Lakers.
Come on. Tell us all. Which player on the Lakers out of that whole roster is in your mind? Tell me right now. What's their number? Who is it?
Brandon Ingram.
Yeah, take a. Oh, what are we thinking, Brandon Ingram?
This is crazy. Come on.
I'm comfortable with me trying to figure this out.
Go ahead.
It's almost like a Ouija board. It's subconscious.
Okay. Corey has
Let's do this. Go back in time. Not a baby. Your first kiss. I bet this is something you haven't thought about for quite some time.
Been a while.
Yeah?
Been a while, yeah.
Is there any way anybody here would know that?
No.
Think of it right now. If I turn this around and it's got the name of your first kiss, would you be freaked out?
I'd be totally freaked out.
So would I. I'm not sure. Yes, that it does not say that. That would have been blown away. It just got a lot of different letters on there. Just a mess. But it's all about seeing patterns. Mentalism is figuring out what people are thinking. You want to be able to see this closely.
Okay.
Think of her name. Can we see this? Yeah, there we go. And imagine those letters starting to melt away.
Oh my gosh.
Do you see those starting to melt?
Yeah.
Like more and more of those letters are seeming to melt away. I'm seeing an S appear. What else have we got? Do you see that? Kind of starting to melt. Tell us her name. It starts with an S, doesn't it? Is that right?
Yeah.
And I'm getting more.
Oh my gosh.
Almost
this
all.
This is crazy.
Is it?
I'm going to turn this around just so you can see this melting. Is that?
This is crazy.
Is that Sherry?
That's okay. That's weird.
Oh my gosh.
Nobody here would know that because it was a fourth grade.
You think he's going to win? No scores. Just write down really quick, and write down the score, too. And I want you to turn this way, Greeny, and plug your ears. I want you to plug your ears, and you should hear a voice in your head. Jalen, tell me. I don't want him to hear anything or see anything. Did you write down who you think's going to win?
I did.
And the score, you think?
I did.
Okay. Do me a favor. Greeny, open your eyes. Swear that I never talked to you about this before this moment. You had no idea. Who do you think's going to win this game?
Who's he?
Who's he?
Seton Hall.
What's the score going to be?
Like 80 to 73?
Wait. I don't like this. I don't like this. It's creepy and you got in our brains. O's. You said what? You heard,
I heard a voice. I had my fingers like this and I heard a voice say, Jalen is picking Seton Hall, 80 to 73.
What?
A voice in my head. It just sounded like a person talking.
Mailer.
Dude. That was the strangest thing that's ever happened to me in my entire life.
Danny Wolverton is an American magician who calls himself Special Head. On his YouTube channel, he says, quote, "My aim is to expose America to more mystical and Eastern practices. The physical world is the illusion, and the spiritual world is what is real. Through my performances, I intend to bring us back to an age of mysticism, reminding people that performance is a ritual and that magic can be spiritual."
My name is Special Head. When I was traveling the world, I met a guru in Turkey who taught me how to control my body, mind, and spirit. What I do is referred to by some people as levitation. My first audition, the response that I received was phenomenal.
You're going to Vegas!
Special Head promotes public nudity and was kicked out of his high school for streaking. That is, running around in the nude.
I even got kicked out for streaking, and my high school recorded this amazing video and produced it. Thank you, Amphitus team.
He is thankful that someone recorded it. On Special Head's official YouTube channel, he promotes his appearance on America's Got Talent as, quote, "demon magician Special Head deals with the devil."
This is my voodoo skull.
Oh my goodness! You're levitating! And he's in a trance! This is unbelievable.
Oh gosh, are you okay? Are you alright?
You've broken the guy's neck.
How am I doing that?
Oh!
How's it doing?
This man just watched Special Head levitate and is stunned.
And a sight with my eyes. I can't believe it! This man need to be talked about. I'm telling you. That's some powerful stuff there, brother.
Darcy Oak is the biggest magician in Canada and one of the fastest growing magicians in the world. His magic videos on the internet have over 100 million views. Darcy started practicing magic at the age of 10. Darcy was also a finalist on Britain's Got Talent. This is the biggest magician in the Middle East. His name is Ahmed El Bayid. His start in magic began at the age of 5 after his grandfather taught him a trick. He has worked many false signs and wonders in his area of the world. Notice that he, like many of the other top magicians, likes to wear a shirt with a skull on it. Those who are into the occult have a fascination with death. God says in Proverbs 8:36, quote, "All who hate me love death. Hell is also eternal death." In Apocalypse 21:8, the Bible calls hell the second death, the one after a person's physical death. That's why these magicians clothe themselves with death. Their magic comes from hell.
Deep into my eyes, you're gonna feel a surge of energy.
It's a scary moment for the 18-year-old.
What do you see?
And we were just backstage, and she said, "Chris, can you do something with me?" You know, and I kind of got inside her mind, and she saw death in me, and she completely lost her mind. She completely freaked out.
What was that?
People see different things.
What was that?
It's what you saw in me. I want them to see and smell death.
Apocalypse 21:8, quote, "But the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable and murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars, they shall have their portion in the pool burning with fire and brimstone, which is the second death." Notice that sorcerers are specifically named among those who will receive eternal death and everlasting fire in hell.
I've had this nightmare of dying in a fire.
Jesus describes hell as a place of never-ending fire, and Apocalypse 14:11 refers to those in hell who have no rest day or night. The Greek word for sorcerer could also be translated as magician. The magicians I have covered were taken over by demons and possessed as a result of involvement in the occult or a desire to interact with spirits. They may have also gotten possessed by being in a state of grave sin or deliberately opening their minds up to the devil. Those are just some of the ways that demons have possessed individuals such as magicians. It is during the process of demonic infestation and interaction that a regular magician who previously could only perform tricks by natural acts of deception becomes a sorcerer, even though he is still called a magician. Through demonic influence and the help of evil spirits, the sorcerer magician is able to do things that defy a natural explanation. In this clip, magician Matt Franco thanks a person on TV for calling him a sorcerer after one of his, quote, magic tricks.
You are like a sorcerer.
Thanks, Kelly.
You are a sorcerer.
I was just saying that it's original illusions that have more in common, like the special effect wizard deeds.
As a practitioner in the art of conjuring, I'm actually able to do things now that, as a kid, I could only dream about.
This is like Harry Potter for real.
Dynamo's not a musician himself, he's a magician. Like a modern-day Merlin, let's say. Will you say that?
Yes, that's good. I like that.
New and aspiring magicians who desire to learn how to perform the most elite magic acts may at first think that it's a skill one can acquire through lots of hard work. For most magicians, they start out in magic simply with tricks that don't utilize supernatural assistance. The amateur magician enjoys the power or thrill he gets when performing the trick. He also enjoys the astonishment and wonder he causes in others who can't figure out how he did it. This can provide a strong temptation to move up to the next level, to do what it takes to be even more successful in astonishing and impressing others. Some magicians may then aggressively search for the, quote, secret knowledge that enables them to do more, with some being willing to do almost anything to become a top magician.
When I was a kid, my dad was messing around with cards. I'd pick one, he pulled it out, and it was my card. I experienced that feeling of, like, how did you do that? And I wanted to do that to other people.
If the magician is aggressive in his search, he will discover that reaching the highest level of success in magic involves dabbling in the occult, submission to, or contact with a spirit. If that happens, the demon can enter the person or strongly influence or control him. This is why we see the top magicians immersing themselves in the occult, seances, contacting spirits, etc. The true God has revealed that practicing magic is similar to playing with a Ouija board. It's a way people open themselves up to demonic possession. Sadly, some are willing to let the devil have some control if it will enable them to achieve success or get what they want. The more a magician is open to the devil's influence, the more thoroughly the devil will control or influence him. The devil wants people involved in magic, but he won't get many interested in it if his top performers, his sorcerers, are doing things like foaming at the mouth. No, he wants his top magicians to come across as balanced, down-to-earth men, normal people who have cool skills.
Don't burn us magician guys, we're just guys doing cool stuff, you know?
The devil has gradually introduced the masses to the diabolical false religion of magic by presenting magic as if it's harmless fun and entertainment. But Satan uses magicians to deceive people and lead them to hell. In the Old Testament, Aaron turned his rod into a serpent before Pharaoh. Pharaoh's magicians were also able to turn their rods into serpents. But then Aaron's rod devoured the magician's rods. Jesus warns that in the last days, quote, there shall arise false Christs and false prophets, and shall show great signs and wonders, insomuch as to deceive, if possible, even the elect.
I can prototype supernatural powers in my career, so I know what it feels like to fly. I know what it feels like to disappear. I know what it feels like to restore things from badness.
The signs and wonders Jesus mentions can include things such as false miracles. The magicians covered in this video certainly fit this prediction.
Now that you've seen it, my dear, now that you've all looked at it carefully, may I show you a miracle? She says, that's impossible. Of course it's impossible. That's why we do it.
And you wouldn't believe it, but you can create a miracle with just about anything.
Earth, wind, fire, water. How can I manipulate those elements to create an apparent miracle.
We're going to have to create miracles.
Well, the TV show, I did about 100 plus episodes and created, you know, miracles on TV.
You know, I'm going to create miracles in the audience.
And you see miracles literally inches away.
I had such an amazing experience creating this show. It does feature some, you know, some intimate miracles.
I don't even know what you
That's
did.
That's not even a trick, is it?
It's not a trick. What I do is not tricks. Some people perceive it to be supernatural.
So I don't want people to be tricked. I'm not showing them a trick. It's about magic.
I have probably about 100 and something people working on the show. What the difference is between me and everybody else is everything, honestly. And I don't say that like in a bad way. The way I look, what I do, my artistic vision is very different. I don't believe in tricks. I don't believe in people wondering how does he do that. I care about how people feel when they watch it.
Again, Jesus describes those who do these false signs and wonders as false Christs and false prophets. These magicians work wonders that some believe are similar to what Jesus did. They cannot do what Jesus did. But God allows the devil to use magicians to perform numerous signs that deceive people. They are false Christs performing false signs and wonders. They are attempting to either replace Christ or claim that they are like him while preaching a false gospel.
Who's the greatest magician, Dave, besides yourself?
Jesus Christ.
In the next clip, Chris Angel is angry because he feels Magician Dynamo stole his signature pose, which Chris says he got from Jesus.
But he even like steals my like my tableau, my pose, you know. Now, I didn't invent that pose. That's depicted by Jesus Christ, but I was the guy to do that in magic, you know, and the way that I look and my image.
Chris says that he's the one who originally started using that pose in magic. When Jesus was crucified, his flesh was pierced with nails and he hung on a cross for 3 hours. It's interesting that on one occasion, Chris Angel had hooks inserted into his back and then attached to a helicopter so that he could fly around in the air in his quote signature pose. He did something similar on another occasion. He described it in his book saying, quote, I hung for 3 hours. This is Chris Angel's Las Vegas dressing room for his show Believe. As you can see, Chris put up on his wall this blasphemous cross with his skullhead image on top of it. As you can see on chrisangel.com, Chris describes this image as the, quote, Chris Angel skull logo. So he puts his logo on the cross and places it up on display on his wall. This is a blasphemy against Jesus Christ. This is a famous Greek magician who has levitated on a number of occasions. Notice how when he levitates, one foot goes over the other. Most believe that when Jesus was crucified, one nail went through both of his feet. David Blaine is also a false prophet and a false Christ. In this clip, notice that he puts his arms out like he is Christ being crucified. Blaine uses words to describe his quote miracles that have been used to describe real miracles of God. Quote, for those who believe, no explanation is necessary. For those who do not, none will suffice. At the end of his interview on a show, Hans Klock was asked to do some tricks. The person doing the interview says Hans is, quote, like Jesus.
What I really want to see, Hans.
Yeah.
I want to see those hands.
Those hands.
Do some tricks.
Their hands. Okay. I show you some sleight of hands. That's this. And the Dutch are quite famous for doing this.
Hey!
I show you some
wow,
more.
Wow, that is proper good.
I show you
good.
Some more. Look.
I'm stood right next to you.
Look, I have cards.
Yep.
Just ordinary cards.
Okay.
Watch this.
What? This?
We do this for the camera?
Yeah.
I do one more for you. This is one of my first tricks. Beside the bottle one.
Bring it on.
It's ordinary newspaper.
Yeah. Okay, read that.
Oh. So.
He's actually ripping this, by the way.
Yeah. Thank you for telling the audience. Here we go. Here you go. Thank you for the interview. Oh, you can keep this, by the way. This is a present.
That is astounding.
Thank you.
You're like Jesus.
Some of Jesus's most well-known miracles were walking on water, multiplying loaves and fishes, and changing water into wine. This is a magician named Yif. He is the most famous magician in China. He has appeared to change water into wine. He says that Jesus was a magician like him who lived 2,000 years ago and performed this miracle.
创意是什么？其实是很难定义的两个字。对我来说，它就像每晚不让你睡觉的魔鬼，折磨着你，牵引着你，探索这个世界的边缘，让你时时刻刻活在可能和不可能之间的那个时空。咖啡。 咖啡，我们来挑战向一个传奇致敬。
Yeah. Happen you do this, watch.
Holy shit.
It's actually spinning, you know. Goes right through my fingers.
Oh my god, like I really don't get
this! What the fuck? I take all my receipts, put them back, and then I count to three. This goes very fast. One, two. Watch. It's all money.
Oh snap!
Hey! Watch this face. I'm gonna show how this is real. So I'm gonna go one, two, and watch. You go right through the bill.
That was very perfect. Where'd the cap go?
Wow.
What?
Oh my god.
Do it again.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Corona. Okay, watch here. Because you're underage.
Yes.
Watch.
Not in Canada.
Oh.
What? What?
Okay. Watch here. It's a snowball. Watch here. You take it. Okay, watch. Where are you from? This is my hand.
Oh!
It's floating, it's floating. Watch it goes through here, watch. Ah! I threw. Yeah. Do you know how we take care of all this snow in Sweden?
No.
No. Well, this is something for IKEA. Watch here. It's magic. It's magic. Sweden is magic. Welcome to Sweden.
Thank you.
But evil men and seducers shall wax worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived, deceiving and being deceived, deceiving and being deceived, deceiving and being deceived.
Hey, you can't be drinking alcohol in a public place. You gotta bring that inside.
But I'm not drinking it, sir.
I just saw you. I can cite you for drinking alcohol.
I put it back in a paper bag. Is it okay? I just put it back like this.
Where are you from?
I'm from Sweden. Police officer, come on. I'm not drinking. I told you, there's nothing here.
Okay, quit playing around. You gotta bring that inside.
Officer, come on. There's nothing in the bag. Watch here. I just told you. Have you been drinking, sir?
We're gonna bring you downtown. Look, is that yours? You gotta bring that in too. And that's littering. I can cite you for that as well.
Officer, I just told you, I'm drinking Coke. I'm not drinking beer.
That's it.
Ladies and gentlemen, I want to try and do something that's never been done before. Can all of you take out your mobile phones? And I want you to just hold them up in the air. Can you all do that for me? Judges, I'd like to stand up and have a look at the audience.
Oh my God. That's crazy.
How are you doing that?
In today's world, we're all connected through our cell phones. But what I want to show you is that we're actually all connected on a far deeper level. Simon, you'll notice that a few of the devices are still red.
Yeah.
I want you just to choose three of them to come and join me on stage.
Pick the one that's all the way in the end.
You, please.
This one.
In the red. Yeah. And you. Come on.
Tara, can you bring your phone as well? Can you just unlock the phone and open the calculator? Okay, that's okay. Great. Okay, here's what I want to do. So I want you to try and guess for me. How many number one selling artists do you think Simon Cowell has had on his record label?
53.
Tara, could you just type in 53?
Yeah. All right, I'm typing in now.
Go for 53. It. And then secondly, how many millions of records do you think Mel, when she performed the Spice Girls, sold worldwide? Just go for it, millions.
102.
Tara, can you hit multiply?
Times.
Yeah, and then 102.
102. Okay.
Okay, and next up, I want you to try and guess what year Heidi began modeling.
Oh.
Oh, it's a hard one.
Sorry, I'm so bad at math. 1970. Nope, 1980.
Not when I was born.
Oh, okay, sorry. 1987?
87, okay. Tara, can you hit multiplied?
Okay.
And then just 87?
87.
Wonderful. Okay, and then here's what we're going to do. Hit the plus sign.
Plus.
Fantastic. Now, a little buddy told me, Harry, that you've had a lot of girlfriends. But instead of just guessing, Tara, what I want you to do is I want you to have your thumbs over the numbers.
Thumbs over numbers.
Now, I want you to make a random guess. I want you to close your eyes and just hit maybe like 7 or 8 numbers. Go
for it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Okay, cool. Hit equals.
Equals.
Okay, sweet. Now, I just want you to read that number out for me. Is that okay?
Okay, ready?
Go for it.
73 million.
Okay, 73 million.
928,000.
928,000.
547.
547. Wonderful, guys. Give a round of applause for these three volunteers. Thank you. And for Tara Banks, please take a seat. Thank you.
It's not over yet, is it?
Take a seat, guys. Thank you very much. Okay, guys, so we've got this random number here, but
there's something bigger going on. There's something impossible. Something magical.
I want you guys to see this.
I'm here on Hollywood Boulevard. It's a few hours until my audition. This number, 73,928,547. Does this mean anything to you?
Thank you.
What?
But wait. Do you remember at the start, I said that we're all connected on a far, far deeper level?
Yeah.
Well, Simon, I think you'll find that you've actually had 47 number one selling artists. And Mel, you sold 85 million records with the Spice Girls.
Yes.
Heidi, you started your career in 1992 when you won Models 92. And Howie, you and I both know that you've not had 73 girlfriends. But that's because you married your high school sweetheart. And you've been married to her for 37 years.